in doping form, you can test me.
.4, the GL gonna be off the charts. So, didn't hold back at all on food, nothing like that. Training weight, like waking up in the morning, I've been anywhere from like 99 to 100. It's possible that my scale is just a little bit off. I smashed food last night, I smashed food and water this morning, so I weighed in where I weighed in, I feel good. We're gonna go chill, go for a quick walk, and you know, just kind of final revision of the game plan, and then we'll get into it.
Let's go.
We're excited.
What's the plan now? So, cafe time?
Yeah, it's gonna hang, man. Like, I don't like sitting around the comp and like dwelling on the nerves too much. I just like to get moving. Mm. And normally before I train on the weekends as well, in the mornings I'll get out and just have a little bit of a walk, get the body moving. It's a little earlier than I'm usually up. What time is it? We're in a goofy mood and that's a good sign. Let's go.
He's a robot. You know what he is? He's a fucking forklift in disguise.
You missed that. I literally said to him, I was like, "Hey, you wearing a hoodie?" He goes, "Is it hot?" Like a fucking robot.
I genuinely thought it was cold today.
No, bro. There's a sip yip in every state, bro. We got given the shitty robot, bro. This motherfucker isn't updated. This fucking version 1.0.
It's a spider maker thing.
It's just the same guy that asked if it's hot.
I think I'm
broken.
Are you okay? It's hyped it up. It's hyped up. Alright, isn't that cool?
You can't go wrong.
I should trip the dill.
I am not gonna have a spider, because I don't wanna.
You probably have to be hyped it up.
I don't wanna crap when I spider.
Like, how do you get the spider?
Ice cream to you?
Where's the ice cream?
Oh, they do it.
Exactly. I thought it added ice cream as well.
Oh, so you're more mind-blown than me.
Yeah.
He thought that it would like eject the cola and then eject the ice cream. And he was losing his mind.
Oh, it's sold out.
I'm gonna try the super dry.
There's definitely something suspicious going on with Chris.
It's not Chris, it's the lizard today.
I've got to get your warm-up as well. I kind of penciled it in.
Yeah, I'll suss that, that's easy. Watch out. But it might be.
You're rigged out, eh?
Be a good by a second. Be the
change. Discuss flight order, where he's at. He's going to be in the second one. He's got 10 girls, 9 guys in the second flight. So it's going to be a pretty quick day. Don't know the other competitors, but I think given Maddie's training, his numbers, probably be sitting towards the end. So we do have a bit of extra time. I think he's already eaten. He's got to take a quick dump. And then we'll also get his rack heights. And then, what time is it now?
Damn.
8:50. In my head, what, 10 girls, about 30 attempts. He'll be on about 9:30. His ninth will be 10:39. So about 10 o'clock, we'll start warming up.
Would you just go through with Danny on the phone?
Just the basics, warm-up strategy, which, I mean, Danny's with me the majority of my training days. I won't be doing anything different. Actually, my attempts work out really nicely for what I'd normally do for warm-ups. Namely, like on the squat, I really like going from 170 to 210 to 240. And then my opener today is going to be 260, so that actually works really, really nicely. So just getting all that sorted. He's got a sheet he likes to use. Every coach likes to do it differently. His sheet just spits out like a start warm-up time. But I mean, it kind of falls in line with what you'd normally do. Like, half an hour before the session starts, you're getting ready. I'm going to be in the second group, so you give yourself enough time to get warm. So yeah, basic stuff. This just feels like a normal training session. I'm trying to keep it as chill as possible beforehand, because I know I'm going to dial in once I'm under a bar. I find that it comps coming in. Like yesterday, I was extremely nervous, and I don't really want to eat, but I made myself eat enough. Like I said before, I ate big last night. And then I find on the day, I relax a lot. And this morning, just been trying to like talk shit, have some fun. And then I know as soon as I touch the bar, and especially once I squat 70 and I feel like, ooh, my body feels nice, that's when I really channel in and dial in naturally, just let it happen. So yeah, looking forward to that. But at the moment, really just trying to keep it chill, not like waste any unnecessary energy. Yeah. Big shout out to Aiden Potts and the crew at Hunter Performance Center. This is their sort of 2.0 facility. So I competed back in late 2022 at their previous facility. I'm pretty sure it was also an anniversary cup. So I'm always looking to support my boy when I can. So we're here competing, showing off the gym on the vlog. They've made it look brilliant. Everything is set up nicely. It's always a really great atmosphere. And I think actually because this venue is a little more condensed, so it's a double story, we're on the upper level right now. It's a little more condensed. I actually expect it to be louder from like a spectator standpoint, which is always better for the competitors. So yeah, looking forward to it. But big shout out to the crew here at Hunter Performance. You guys have done a really good job.
Give us a rundown of your role as a handler. All
right, so my role as a handler is to make sure this guy can just focus on lifting. So simple things, just making sure he's warming up on time. You know, he's not speeding up, going too fast or going too slow. And then
it's plugged in though, so cool.
Matty's already really good with load selection. Marcellus has already given him a plan. So I'm just there to facilitate that, make sure he doesn't get too ahead of himself, or also if he needs to back himself. That's all I'm doing for. Yeah, chilling. It's not really my day, it's his day. So I'm just secondary about it.
And for someone who's like not as experienced in comps, what would you want from like an optimal client handling them on a day?
I think from personal experience, when I was starting out, I was very intuitive as well. I would have an idea of like, all right, this is potentially what I've got left. And if the coach kind of agrees with that, then we run with that. Right? But you know, if you're the type of person who's overconfident and you've like run it and you go, all right, I'm good to add 15 kilos, you try it, and then it just doesn't pan out that way, maybe next time that's a learning lesson, right? You might need to go through that a couple times and then you realize, oh, I know, but like mentally, I think I'm good for 15, but I'm gonna take 10, something like that.
I think as well, like I've competed at competitions in those like 17 comps. I've had comps where I've missed thirds, where I've come off the platform. Like I remember when I was less experienced, like Hazy was coaching me at a comp, and I hit a second, and like, it was rubbish, it was weak, and I made him put an attempt in that I wanted emotionally to get. I think that's the biggest difference, is being able to disconnect from what you emotionally want to get to what you feel that you have. And that's where I'm at now, where I feel absolutely confident that no matter how the second goes on each of the lifts, I'm going to come off and give an honest insight into what I believe that I have, not what I'd like to have. And that's just probably the easiest distinction to make between getting more experience, and like 17 comps is some, but I think there's people with even more experience, and I'm sure I'll learn more things. But you learn less and less and less the more comps you do. There's only so much you can learn. So I'm very confident in my abilities, and also very confident in my insights about my performance. So
it gets intuitive to a point.
That's right. It does. Absolutely does. So that'll be good. Just like training. It's like training, baby.
Hey, who am I? Hello, Aiden Potts, Director, Hunter Performance Center. First comp here today at our new venue. Very excited. Only 20 lifters though, but that's the point. Try to keep it small so we can, you know, iron out all the kinks before our next big comp in July, which is First Nations Cup on the 6th, 7th this year. So make sure you book the tickets if you want to get into that one, because that's going to be huge. Two-day event, primetime session. If you've got 90 GL, you can get into the primetime. So look forward to that. And yeah. Talking to you, James.
Whoa!
90 GL, brother. You hit that, don't you?
Oh, like on a good day.
On a good day?
Yeah.
My name is Ben Roberts. I'm one of the coaches here at Hunter Performance Center. So I'm here today for the competition for a few athletes of myself and Aiden's. So just running through a few of the boys so they can tick the box to qualify for Junior Nationals in 2 weeks' time. And then a few of the boys actually gone for a bit of a send as well at their first competition. So it's going to be good fun. I'm looking forward to the outcome of the day. Goals this year as a coach for myself is basically just continue growing the team that I currently have in terms of numbers on my roster, and then the quality of the athletes that I have, just continuing to proceed to take them into new PR territory consistently through all of their training blocks. Got a good few of them that might hit the regionals total qualifier at Nationals for the juniors, so that'll be pretty good. Hopefully get a few of them to Oceanas, and then hopefully apply myself to get on the coaching team there as well, which would be really nice. Exciting.
Introduce yourself and tell us what your role is here.
Hi, I'm Kerry Smith, and I am currently helping out on the comms with tech desk. We run everything onto the computer for the flight schedule.
How'd you get into it?
Aiden made me do it in the first comp.
He robbed you in!
Said I'd get lots of money.
Oh no.
It happened.
Like just a heel elevation or something. To do like a
slant.
Anything like that. Even plates would be okay, but if you can find a slant downstairs, maybe there might be something. See how you go. That's fine. Yeah.
Alrighty, coaches, if you can make it up the platform that's for 1 minute, so they can give you a quick briefing. Thank you.
I like to get away from it a little bit between attempts as well, whether that's like outside or like somewhere like this. So most lifters at local comps, they stay around the platform, which is fine. I just like to get away for a minute and then come back. So this could be a good spot. Having someone to help is like actually the runaround stuff. Like on comp day, you just like put shit places, forget about it. It's nice to just be like, hey, my thing's upstairs, can you go get it? Just so you can chill out. So Danny's a weapon.
70, 120, 170, 210.
Warm-ups, I'll be planning just like out there to be like more than good on deck.
Yeah.
Just all day. Start then. Stay hydrated. Don't wait till you're dehydrated. It's warm in here. So just keep sipping. Best hydration uptake is when you're just sipping. If you realize you're dehydrated and dump it down, it's not quite as good. So just keep it chill, keep it hydrated. I've got some pre-workout that I keep sipping on. I've got my energy drink, a bit of Gatorade. It's chill, it's just like training, baby.
Who's up, Michael?
Danny, anything you need to be saying maybe? Just heavy in the feet, low in the feet. That's it.
Beautiful.
Just jumping 15. And for Manny. Let's go, Manny.
That's cool, that's the high side.
Well done, buddy.
No, it's a bit shaky. We walked out. So I'll see how that goes on the next one. I'll pay attention to it, but we'll see how the second moves.
Yeah.
It's alright.
What do you got, man?
Just keep doing the right things. I think depth was good. I think depth is yellow, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I thought it might have been that, yeah. Right. I was feeling shaky as well, so.
Just gotta own it.
That's it.
Lock these ones out.
Yeah, no worries.
You just hear Steph in the background. Come on, buddy!
I heard that.
Yeah, there you go. That's all you need. You know what I mean.
Right. It's gonna stay in the moment,
okay.
Which is fine. Like, that's why I think I was feeling that way.
Okay.
I was just overspilled a bit.
Yeah.
I was like fucking crying before I went out. So I just need to calm down.
Treat yourself up on the.
I just need to calm down. Yeah. Calm down. Do what I do. Strong through the legs.
Thank you.
But death was great. It is excellent. So because it wasn't the normal high side, it was the right side. Yeah. So I knew it wasn't death. Oh, all right, 280, strong and smooth, that's all we need. We got one red on the opener, yellow card, for a little bit of a soft knee at the start position. I felt pretty shaky on the first one, I was really nervous. So, easy fix.
Anything new?
Just gotta stay composed, man. What am I gonna do? I'm not gonna gym up. I'm just gonna be like, stay composed. That's all I can really do, you know? He knows the vibe he needs to be in, so I'm just going to support that.
Bar's loaded. Let's go, Maddie.
Choice to retake that 280.
to get it on the board, nothing worse. You know what, if you're going up, I miss.
Oh.
If you're going up, I miss.
What does that say?
2.5, I miss.
Yeah.
Today, that's just it. It's fine. Like, what can I do about that today? So, we played it how we play it. Only thing I might have been able to do different is sensor on the opener and drop a little bit. Maybe we'd have got a few more kilos, but it's semantics, isn't it?
Really?
So,
you would have ended up around 280 anyways.
Yeah, maybe slightly more, right? A couple more kilos too, my friend.
Yeah,
obviously, because on the stream, it's not saying whether you got it or not. So, I just let myself know.
What's that, either downward?
I've definitely bobbled at the end of the squat. It's fucking weird. I felt pretty good in the warm-ups. Nothing to sort of comment on. I definitely got a little too heightened for the opener and I was like shaking and shit. I was just a bit too like drummed up. And that happens, it's been, you know, just over a year since I competed. And I'm someone who definitely correlates a lot of emotion with a lifting. Calmed down nicely for the second. So I got one red on the opener for not having my knees locked properly at the squat command. So one referee kept their hand up, majority rules, they give the squat command, but that referee still maintains their red light. So depth was good. Second one, depth calls, both sides. I honestly had very minimal like proprioception for where I was in space. I was just going down and then at some point I was pushing back up, which for me, I normally have a pretty good idea of where I'm at in depth. So I don't know what that is. And just things like pushing out of a hole, like that second one, even when it's like twisted and like...
Yeah, it looked a lot jankier.
It was weird. Like I literally haven't felt that way on a squat. I can't remember like feeling that way on a squat, you know, especially on a comp day. So Marcellus and I will chat on that later. He's actually awake, which is kind of cool. So he's kind of sending me some VMs, which is awesome. But we're just gonna keep focusing on the bench now. There's really no need for an awful lot of analysis at the moment. It's just like, cool, that happened. We ended up probably getting the most amount of kilos we could on the squat, which again, it's just like a big underperformance and you just have to accept that sometimes. So got the 260 open, I missed the 282nd, got the third on 280, and I don't think I had more, like any more, like 2.5 might have undone me. Mm. 5 definitely would have. And having squatted 290 really nicely 4 weeks ago, it's just a down day. We need to figure out why next time. So, just gonna focus on bench. I'm gonna kind of mentally compartmentalize that as like a squat down performance day and wait to see how I feel on bench press. But in the back of our minds, I think it's fair for us to just note that and be like, hey, if anything does feel off early on in bench press, we slightly adjust the plan aware that, you know, there could be a trend. Let's just wait and see. Yeah.
Sounds good.
I'm gonna get some drink into me. I should have 20 minutes to chill out.
Yeah, you got time.
Yeah.
I'll do the numbers for you.
Yeah, that's no stress. I'll get some drink. I'll come and see you guys soon.
Stop. Press.
That just from a system point of view, I was like just way too ramped up in like a few different ways, like. Sure, mega caffeinated like normal, but I was also like fucking like into it emotionally, and I've experienced it before where just crash, become like floppy.
Yeah.
And that's how I felt. So
like you put it all in on the first one, you realize, oh, it's too much.
Not even that I put it all in, I was just in it in that space and heightened to the point that it actually did the opposite, and I kind of was just like, you know, so that's that.
Press. You want to be about like 6 lifters out?
Yeah, like as our group starts, rather than before it starts, which is kind of what we do before, we can go. We don't have to go like 3 deep, we can probably go as we start. It's about 3 minutes.
Next guy will go and then you go.
Yeah.
Stop.
Press.
And the bar is loaded for Maddie. Yeah.
Yeah.
Stop. Press. Rack.
Really speedy. And two white lights. Nice work, money.
My whole mood just changed, don't worry.
He's back! We're back! He's alive! Listen now, Gaib!
What does it say? Drink the... What is it?
Water of life.
The water of life. Even if I hit 177 and I'm like...
That's whoa. Really, really good.
Yeah. Like if that... Like
that's a bonus.
What I'm saying is that if I hit 177 and I could hit 187, I think that even if I feel that way, we'll go for 185 as a maximum.
Yeah.
Momentum. Moving really well.
Yeah, I think it was a nice chill approach. Got into a good spot and the strength was there, and so nothing was forced.
Yeah.
Nice.
We have nothing to do
to qualify. Oh.
Same thing.
Yep.
Final of the second round. That is coming out for 100.
Jump. Here we go, same thing, you're on today, man.
And by playing for money.
I got gas there. I think like I could probably hit the 187. So 185 is good call. Let's get this comp PR, baby.
It just felt effortless, honestly. Straight up nice.
You're gonna smash 185.
Let's get it.
Make a move.
It feels strong, man. It feels very strong.
Let's go, man. It's yours.
Pick two, right on. Beautiful. So happy.
185. Revived. Yeah, really, really happy. Noticeable change in energy, which like almost sucks to say because it's such a novel thing where, you know, for whatever reason, I was just like in the gutter energy-wise for squats, and that showed kind of as soon as I got on the platform for all the attempts. Be that what it is, I just tried to calm down and just felt more normal coming into bench press, and like literally just every like minute or two I felt myself getting better and better in terms of energy. Bench felt like gas today, honestly. 167 and 177 moved really, really well. 185 was good. I expected to maybe have a little more in the tank based on how 177 felt, but it was a good selection and we kind of locked on to that plan. As I like that middle selection based on what Marcellus gave me. But bench PR, you know, feels like I've turned the start of the day around, and now we're just gonna see how we feel on dead. It's kind of same vibe. I think that the energy and the confidence came from actually lifting well and just feeling good.
rather than trying to force anything, which, you know, I think I did that a little bit on the squats where I was trying to get that energy and that arousal to a place and it was just too much. So I'm just going to try and just come in and approach it the same way on deads, keep it chill, which is how I usually behave in training. So, you know, again, it's one of those things like 17 comps deep, still did something fairly novice today at the start of the day. And, you know, maybe strength was down a little bit too and that kind of compounded. But really happy with the bench press, 3 from 3. I think I got 3 whites on all 3 of them.
Yep.
And a bench PR, which is really, really nice. So keen for that.
How's the energy now?
Good. Yeah, just normal. My body feels good. Energy feels normal. I think I'm just going to kind of like nibble on something, have a little bit of water, not try to do anything too crazy, and just let the strength speak. Because deadlifts have felt really, really good this prep. No reason why we can't have a great day on deads. So.
Yeah. Yeah. Very well done.
That's cool.
I've been officially coaching since the end of COVID coming out. I started doing a bit of PT, so that was what, end of 2021, October 2021, so about 3 years of coaching now. Entirely just been powerlifting. I was in gyms for a bit, then I went completely online. So I guess like comparing a comp like this where it's pretty low stakes versus one that's where you've got high stakes. Depending on what the split is, right? Like, if you're the strongest lifter, you could literally just like have your own day, follow your own plan, and not really worry about anyone else as long as you make attempts. If you have that ace of the card, like you're the strongest, like generally, if you can execute, that's how you win the game. You know, if you're a deadlift specialist, you could end up pulling ahead. As long as you execute, you just gotta stay close enough to the pack to be able to do that. And that comes to not being greedy. You also don't want to like hella undershoot things either, and make sure that you are staying close enough to be able to put what you need on the bar to be able to pull for the win or put yourself into a podium position that you think is realistic. Compared to a day like this, you know, nothing really at stake, no prize money, no nothing. So I think the goal for Maddie and Marcellus is, you know, it's their first comp together, build confidence together. They get to test their taper strategy, which they are. And he's on track to total PR. So, you know, like little personal wins like that you could gain, you know, on a low stakes meet, like if there's a PR, you could take it, right? Like there's no no need to hold yourself comparing other people's numbers to try and vie for placing. It's not that important. You're not gonna end up getting any sort of progression out of it. Unlike something like, you know, vying for a position for going to Worlds or something like that. So yeah, just have fun. Total PR would be nice, or time PR, even better.
I'm gonna reveal my secrets and tricks.
Inside and in front, like pretty standard.
Yeah, you don't have to rub it in or anything, just whack it on. Yeah, a bit more here. Done. That's fine.
Just the one side?
No, both sides. Just step it away. Yeah, bro, just a split stance. Do some split stance business.
Some Jefferson action.
About 4 minutes, we're gonna go 170.
Cool. Let's just chill out here between.
Okay.
Let's chill out here. Cool. Chill with the homies.
Bit more relaxed now, Matty?
Yeah, it's good, man. I've settled into the day. I think that's the lesson is like, if I'm gonna get, it's funny, I kind of like was so relaxed beforehand. And then I was like, yeah, let's turn it on now. And then I just overcooked the shit out of that. And then it came down, and then I'm back to where I should be. I think that, you know, maybe whatever it is, like get more excited beforehand, let that happen. So that when it comes to squats, it's like we have what we have now, which is just feeling just fine, you know? I don't need to do anything special on the day from a mental standpoint. I think I just, yeah, just bummed out a little bit with the squats.
I want you there in 3 minutes, yeah. So I'll just go in, make sure it's all loaded up.
Yeah. I'll head in 1 minute and see you.
Cool.
Yeah. So yeah, I feel good now. And I'll send it to Danny, like, mindset for bench was just like, you're as strong as you are, and just get in there and don't force anything. And I think it's the same with deadlifts. However strong I am today on deadlifts is however strong I am on deadlifts. So I'm just gonna relax a bit, you know? Still wanna have that intent, but I'm not gonna be too hard on myself. I'm just gonna go in and, you know, with the bench press that created a really great performance, I think that'll be the same on deadlift. So, take it one at a time.
This one?
I have to keep constant tension on it, okay. From rolling, which I'm okay with, but
understood. You prefer that?
Yeah, one more, 220.
last one, then it gives you about 8 minutes spread into your open after. We'll chuck baby powder on for the
we'll chuck on after powder.
So I noticed Matty B had his belt on even on 70 kilos. Like, what's the point of that?
Just to get primed. It's like, you can feel confident on 70, you're going to carry that through all the way to 170. And proprioceptively, you're getting the same effect, right? Like, you can push out into the belt, feels good. Don't think he necessarily needs it, but the confidence and getting a similar feel from 70 to 120 to 170, why not? Down.
Let's go. Got about 9 lifters now. Jumps might change depending on how big everyone else jumps. So you might get extra time instead of second.
Easy.
And just chill out here?
Yeah.
More breathing room.
Yeah, exactly. Feel solid.
Nice.
Just let it run. How I would hope to be feeling. Open them if speedy. I'm focusing on making sure my knees are locked out, which is something that in training I can sometimes have soft knees, so I'm just making sure they're locked out hard, which actually just threw me under my toes a little bit there. I still got 3 whites, but just gonna make sure we're pulling back a little bit more on this one to just make sure that nothing happens there. So I'm gonna stay over it from the knee. I'm just gonna focus on pulling back. Keep it simple. Smooth 275, doesn't need to be anything crazy, just smooth.
Wake up the Hercules in you.
Max attempt is going to be a minute. Usually lifters don't take the full minute, but you can account for that with the time that they're loading, so about 4 minutes out.
Let's go, buddy.
on another 20. 20 is going to be a bit of a reach.
Yep.
15 will be pushing it. 10, I think.
Yep. Let's load 290 then.
Alright.
That's coming down from 292.
Yeah.
Felt solid. Just felt like a little bit slippy in the right one. Got a little bit deep on it. Might have a look.
Different to how that first was.
Okay.
So I think execution wise, that's probably is going to be what's coming back. Speed wise, off the floor.
Great. Like, it didn't feel bad by any stretch. And the 292 is the B plan.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. Alright. 292 then, yeah?
Yep.
From the 290 to 292.5.
Thank you.
He goes 255 to 275. Speed looks a little different from first to second. But that being said, he's still holding enough to potentially total PR right now. So we spoke about like what's at stake at a local meet, right? So like 292.5 is the total PR for Maddie. So you know, if it's there, let's take it. That's about it. I think 290 to 292, the potential payoff to get 292, a lot greater if he hits it and finishes out the day. So let's go for that.
Harder and get over to that finger.
Bit more iron.
I felt it straight away.
Okay.
I was like in there and I was like, oh, don't worry about it. Just keep moving.
Yeah.
So I just need to keep it more fingertippy.
Okay.
Get across, get the fingertips, just trust it. And then we load in and I'll be able to push harder there too.
Yeah.
Naturally, like it was rolling a bit. So I just kind of chill through the end.
Yeah.
So get it locked down. That's where it starts. And then we'll just fight like hell.
Yeah.
Give it everything.
Yeah, man. Yeah. It's gonna be screaming at you.
Yeah, bro.
That's all we need.
That's
just
it.
Hype now.
Empty the tank on it. Hold that initial position and then just fucking give it guts all the way to the top.
Let's go, baby.
That's it.
You want back slaps on this one?
No, I'm okay. We're good for this.
Go,
Gary. Come on, Gary. Let's go. Come on.
Everything you got. Go.
Come on.
Next up and heavy set of the day at 292.5, Manny Barber. Drop that bar down. And the bar is loaded for Manny. Let's go,
Manny!
Get in the room.
Well, come on, walk us through that one. What happened?
I don't know, man. Nothing.
How was it, the rip that time?
Yeah, fine.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. It was on my mind to kind of make sure I said it right, but it felt reasonable.
Yeah.
I don't know, honestly.
It's just heavy.
Yeah, it's an all too familiar feeling of being like, you can do it on the deadlift and then fucking failing, you know? So, I think that was. And 290, 292, I don't think it would make an awful lot of difference, to be honest with you. Mm. For that, like, that is nowhere close.
Mm.
You know? So, yeah, it's rough. I don't think I really have any
any thoughts on that at the moment? It's just like, just 12 seconds ago, so I'm just like, you know.
Feels bad.
Feels real bad.
This is a really small comp because we just want to kind of get the kinks out with this new facility. So thank you to all 19 lifters who came up from Sydney or down from Portland Quarry, wherever you're from. Obviously, this is going to get better and better and better because we tried out some new things here today. But thank you for being part of it. A big thank you to Greta for approving two new local referees. Congratulations to Jordana and Aaron, who have spent their time studying and obviously passing to become an NBA referee, so thank you very much. A big thank you to the Swatters and Loaders. I've got a couple of juniors who actually spotted and loaded, who are very close to national, so thank you for your time. Thank you, Sam Forsberg, as well, who's getting ready for Worlds. I appreciate your time as well. thanks to all the members who spent their time putting together the platform, obviously putting all the weights and the display on today, so thank you so much. We'll see us in July. That's our next competition, which will be bigger. First Nations Cup, which will be on the 6th and 7th of July, which will be massive. So looking forward to seeing you guys then. Appreciate your time and safe drive home.
Alright, so wrapped up, keep it objective, came in, squatted a 260 opener, missed a 280 on depth after that, retook and got it, but it was pretty tough, considering I've hit 290 in competition just over a year ago, and I've also squatted 305 in training, and I'm a little bit heavier now. You can definitely call that a bad squatting day, so that's going to be up to muscles and I to go check that out and decide the variables we feel led to that. Obviously it's disappointing coming in. Squat is usually the lift I feel the most consistent in and reliable, but not today. And I think that the positive there is that we handled it well and we got the kilos, so we didn't go up. I think I would have missed if I went up, so we didn't kind of be left with a 1-for-3. That would have been terrible. So we did, you know, showcase some self-control there. Bench was outstanding. I'm super happy about bench press, and I need to give myself credit for that because I'm currently just like beating myself up about having a shit day. But bench was good, and I think bench was almost the one. It's so funny, bench was the one I was like, oh, I wonder if bench will show up. I was telling everyone. It's like squat's feeling great, deadlifts feel great, bench been feeling okay, but bench was the one that was the most consistent, strong, reliable, and I'm very happy to be saying that, and it feels like bench is moving forwards. Deadlifts, I felt like were going to go well when I hit my first and my second. I didn't really sense that there was anything wrong, things were moving well, and I was like, huh, maybe this is just a bad squat day and we're going to finish with a nice bench and a nice deadlift. Unfortunately, 292 and a half, not even close to there, and that's surprising as well. Having recently pulled 290 on the same day as squatting 290, you know, there's nothing awfully different about the way I train. So that one's a little bit of a head scratcher. And so it'll be interesting to see where we go with problem solving that, be it the program, be it the taper and all those sorts of things. It does make me feel a little bit better that my lower body lifts kind of on average didn't show up, that there wasn't necessarily heaps that I did wrong outside of the one thing I pinpointed about my energy on the squat that I can work on for next time. So that there's a nice, I guess like reassurance in that to be like, hey, there could just be like a slight fix here. We have had really, really outstanding days when we tested in the gym and tapering elements of that went really well. But today, on average, the squat and the deadlift just kind of didn't show up well. So the next thing after this is like, okay, when we are able to piece that together on the platform, we're gonna see a mega boost to the total. It feels very sour to be sitting in that middle of 700s again, like, fuck off. Like, it's one of those, like, if you don't laugh, you cry moments, where I am pretty damn upset, and I think when I think about it more, I'll get more upset. I'm just trying to kind of make light of it at the moment and keep it objective, but I am so keen to actually put something on the platform together that I'm capable of. And it sounds real meme-y to be like, not the day I planned for, but it really wasn't in a lot of ways. We came in with a mindset to be somewhat conservative compared to the expectations from training, and that didn't go well. So we got a bit of like going back to the drawing board to do in a few elements. But don't worry, collectively we're getting stronger, and when we do have that sort of super meat moment, mega meat moment, I know I'll put a lot of kilos in the total, and I will keep working. If there's one thing that I will do is I will stay relentless with it. Even if I fail time and time again, which is what it's feeling like a little bit, but you know, I will get that breakthrough moment, and it's just all about committing enough time to it and not giving up, and I'm determined to not give up here, even though there's a lot right now telling me, is like a lot of like stabs through the heart right now, being like, just stop, you know. That's definitely a feeling that I felt after this. Bro, again, I should be, you know. So we can do better, and that's it. That's the recap. There's a lot in that. I'm sure I'll have more thoughts on this soon. But if you tuned in on this, tuned in on the prep, I appreciate you. I appreciate everyone who came out and supported today, everyone who ran the comp, Aiden, everyone at HPC. Yeah, lots of love, lots of appreciation. Obviously, Marcellus, been really loving working with Marcellus as a coach, and he was there supporting me in real time, even though he's over in the States, which was just excellent. So there's a lot of good. There's a lot of good, and one day does not define your direction. And I just got to make that real. It's all good chat. Just got to make that real. So catch you in the next one. Thanks for tuning in. Peace.